My ghost from a crip to a one percenter. We talk transitioning from gang life to MC culture. They always say in the media that it's the same thing. I'ma break down to you why it's not, and we get into it on this episode of Demons Row TV. No, yeah, we ghosting, baby. Welcome to Demons Row TV, the holy grail of MC culture, where we cover everything Motorcycle Club involved. I'm Sos the Ghost, aka Chopper Sosa. I'm your host for the evening. Happy New Year to all my ghosts. I'm a full year in this game. Shout to everybody that been supporting. Shout to all the new subscribers. New year, we doing new things. And I'm gonna get deep into the type of lifestyle that I've lived, and I'm not gonna hold no cuts. This year we're gonna take it to another level, and I'm gonna tell you about my true origins right now. But the first thing I want you to do is to hit me with that pound ghosting, and that lets me know you're alive and well, sitting on twos, doing what you do, or you just straight up part of the Demons Row community, one of my ghosts. So I got the idea to talk about this because somebody put a comment in the last video that I did, and they said some shit like, oh, he's just a gangster on a bike, he's not a real MC or whatever. So I wanted to explain where I come from and my origins, so you better understand for the new year, why not start from ground zero and explain who I really am. So we're gonna talk transitioning from a crip to a one percenter. How did I end up on that path? It started with my cousin. It's a tale of two cousins for me. One of my cousins, one percenter. One of my cousins, crip. My cousin that was crip, I'ma try to do this without naming names. My cousin that was crip, he was locked up. He was in Green Correctional. I was living in the Bronx at the time, and up north, he turned crip. So when he came home, our neighborhood was predominantly blood. So he started to get into shit in the street with these dudes. So naturally, I took up for my cousin, and I pretty much was labeled. They was already calling me a crip before I was even a crip. So I decided, you know what? This is my family. I'ma jump in. I'ma do what I gotta do to get in this circle. So moving around in circles like that, you bump into other people. So the set that we was claiming was Grape Street. A lot of people know Grape Street, they wear the purple flags. Eastside 103rd, Grape Street Watts, Baby Lil Crip, that's when we was banging. And I bumped it, we was at a strip club one day, and I had bumped into one of the homies from the West Coast. I'm thinking he's like Purple City Bird Gang or some shit like that. So I kind of flexed up on him in the strip club, and he kind of liked my style, and he put me on the game. He was from Cali, so he put me on the game. Like, my cousin had got on, but it was for somebody that was like not official like that. He had heard from somebody else, they put him on. You know, one of those fake type deals where it's not authentic. So I bumped into one of the authentic OGs from Grape, and he put me on. And basically that's what I was for the majority of my life. And my cousin, Sonny, was always trying to put me on a different kind of life, because he was like, yo, that shit ain't getting you nowhere. And you know, it did nothing but bring me jail and problems and losing homies. And it was a lot of dumb shit that I went through being young, being involved with it. But you know, I was repping for my family. And it was so crazy because when I was up north, I'm Puerto Rican. A lot of Puerto Ricans were scared to hang out with me because they didn't want the Bloods to think, oh, yo, we cool with him. He's Crip. He's going to put us on. You know, so it was a crazy life being a Spanish Crip from the East Coast, not from the West Coast, but got put on by West Coast big homies. When you in the gang life, it's so much shit that happens. And I winded up having situations where loyalty was in question. I had my own homies, had to stare down the barrel from people that were like supposedly like brothers to me. And I started to distance myself from everybody. I never officially dropped, because once you down, you always down. You know what I mean? Like, so I never officially dropped, but I just fell back on the circles of people that I was rocking with. And I had chapters under me and everything. So when I came into the MC world, my mentality was completely different. So fast forward, my cousin Sonny, he puts me on to the MC world. He puts me on to even jumping on a bike. He's the one who got me to jump on a bike and just put me on to the life. So jumping into the 1% world, it was a lot more structure, a lot more brotherhood, and I feel like for my personality, it fits me better. I dealt with a lot of struggles because I took the stink from the gang world and brought it into this. So at times, I need my brothers to bring me down because I'm always ready to like resort to a gang mentality, but I don't do it on purpose. It's just what I've seen and what I've been through. It's just the way I think. So I think a lot differently. As y'all know on this show, the way I talk, the things I talk about, the way I move, I'm not your average MC. And I've really lived both lives, so I could tell you that the difference between a gang and an MC is it's completely different. The stakes in an MC are way different from being in a gang. Like in a gang, it just, like we have a saying in New York, in a New York minute, like it just gets crazy quick. In MC culture, it's more respect based. When it comes to gangs, there's no respect. There's all, like the younger homies, all they understand is if something happens, put in work, retaliate, or just do whatever the dumbest shit is so you look the coolest. Like, that's the type of time they on. In MC culture, it's more about respect. It's just a whole different type of atmosphere, and it fits someone like me. And I realized all these years being in gangs, being Crip all my life, what I was looking for was brotherhood. Like, I was siding with my family, you know what I mean? And at the end of the day, when you join a club, make sure that that's your family, like that you have that family atmosphere. And it's just, people have asked me, like, how is it transitioning from a gang into the MC culture? And I think it's dope. I think it's the same things that you were getting from the gang life, but without all the high stakes, without all the danger. It's just a different life, and it's more, you have more brothers that you can rely on. When some shit breaks down, when your bike breaks down, whatever happens, you can call somebody, they'll come. It's just different in gang culture. In gang culture, it's more war-based. Like, when this, they're more like willing to be there for you if something beef-wise happens. To be an actual brother and be there for you if your car broke down and stuff like that, like, that's not really what the Lokes is doing. Shout to all my Lokes too, you know what I mean? It's just a different, it depends on your mind state, what type of shit you on. Like, if you on that, you know what, I want to flip out, that's the type of time I'm on, then Crip is the avenue for you. But if you're getting older and you like the ride and you like the brotherhood and you like it more respectful and not crazy shit going on, that's more MC culture. Now, that's not to say that if something happens, you're not fully protected by your brothers, because in MC culture, your brothers are gonna make sure you get out of spot safe. You know what I mean? So if you have any questions on gang culture, on MC culture, like, you know, transitioning or things that are similar, or if you're actually in a, because I know a lot of MCs that are still affiliated, they're still like blood or they're still Crip and they're in a club. So tell me how y'all feel about that. Any questions you have, as always, cop the Demons Row merch. Shout to everybody who's been supporting the merch. It's been flying off the shelves. I thank you for that. Let me know your resolution for this year. And listen, every day, strive to get better. Don't do that, oh, I'm gonna start working out and then just not even work out bullshit. Like, get on it. Like, every day that you waste and you bullshit is another day that you didn't make it to your dream. So listen, y'all dream big. Any questions y'all got, hit your boy up. Thank you for tuning in to Demons Row TV, the holy grail of MC culture. Like, subscribe, comment, share this. Let people know the truth. Demons Row is here to save everybody. And oh yeah, we ghosting, baby.